into this building.
Yes, Jesus. Hallelujah.
You brought your burdens.
Yes.
Brought your pain. I have a message.
Yes.
For you today.
Hallelujah. Say so, God.
That when you leave here, won't be the same. So you tell me,
hallelujah, Jesus.
You've been to your position.
Glory to God. Hallelujah.
Look at you, there's been no change in your condition. Reach out and touch the master's robe. There's healing for your mind. Oh, your body and your soul.
Yes, hallelujah.
God can heal.
God can heal.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you, Father.
About the situation. But with every test and every trial, there is revelation.
Yes, thank you for the revelation, God.
God is able to supply.
Thank you, Jesus.
So by the time,
yes,
that you leave this building, my prayer for everyone in here is that you'll have your healing.
Yes. Till you bring me
give me your healing, Lord. Thank you, Lord. All things work together for the good of them that love him. All according to his purpose. Thank you, Lord. I receive the healing, Lord. I receive your healing, Jesus. I receive the touch from you. I'll stand and wait on the Lord and think of the courage. But you take the strength of mine. I receive. Is there anybody in here who can reach a hand to heaven? Right where you are. Come on and tell them.
Jesus, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah,
yes, yes,
hallelujah,
oh Jesus,
let's pray.
Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, God.
Yes.
Thank you, God. Oh, hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Take a moment and praise the Lord.
Yes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, God.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Jesus.
Glory. Oh, glory. Glory.
Come on, God. Oh, hallelujah.
Yes,
God. Oh, hallelujah. Romans 16:16 says to greet one another with a holy kiss.
Yes.
All of God greet you. Oh, hallelujah. Ministerial engagement. We welcome you and we greet you today. We not only greet you with a holy kiss, but we greet you with a hug and a big hug. Oh, hallelujah. To God be all the glory. I'm going to tell you all that it is a sweet spirit. Oh, up here. Oh, hallelujah. We're having testimony service before. We came on just talking about the goodness of the Lord God and his power and his might. And hallelujah, I'm witness to a miracle. You hear me? Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, God. And I thank God for doing what he's done.
Yes.
That he continues to do. I give God all the honor, the glory, and the praise as he is the head of my life. He's all of our life, ministerial engagement team. Jesus, to God all the glory. Oh, hallelujah. And we come today, oh, hallelujah, to welcome the Lord God in, because without him, we can't do anything. You hear me? Oh, we can't do anything. Many of y'all will often hear me say, I give God all the honor, the glory, and the praise. Or I give God all the honor. I give God all the praise. And it's because nothing happens except through Jesus Christ. In Philippians 4:13, it says, I can do all things through Christ Jesus that strengthens me. God wants us to walk in it. He wants us to know it. And he wants, 1 Thessalonians 5:18, it says, be thankful in all circumstances, for this is God's, oh, hallelujah, will for you to belong to Christ Jesus. You hear me? And so we have to know who we are. And whose we are, we got to give thanks and praise at all times. Oh, hallelujah, to God be all the glory. I thank God for my shepherd. Oh, hallelujah, Bishop Murphy. I thank God for my overseers. I thank God for all of Team Jesus. Thank God for my co-hosts that are up here today. And Mark 16:15, it says, and he said unto them, go ye into all the world and teach the gospel to every creature. You hear me? And so I have up here daily with me when I'm up here, his apostle that he gave that charge to also. And so I thank God for you, Apostle Davidson, and your dedication and your servitude and being the co-host up here. Amos 3:7, it says that surely God will do nothing except for he reveal it first unto his prophets. And so today's speaker of the hour, our host and our sister that makes it three sisters that absolutely love the Lord, yes. Oh, hallelujah, yes. Is his prophet, Elder Johnetta Little out of Durham, North Carolina, is going to be preaching God's prophetic message on today. And so I ask y'all to help be evangelists, to help spread the word of God, share the broadcast, tag somebody, let them know that there will be a word from the Lord God. God is doing a new thing in this season. He's teaching words and having us to bring forth a word to where it's just blowing my mind and changing me inside, changing us. My baby girl came and gave me a testimony. Mama, every time I watch the broadcast, the next day, I'm walking more in the spirit. I can hear and I'm seeing in the spirit now. And I know for a fact, talking and communing with some of you that are watching.
Yes.
And that y'all have grown. My God. I look at some of you now and you are not the same. Oh, hallelujah. And I thank God for you keeping us in prayer. So I thank God for each one of you, the watchers, those that keep us lifted up in prayer, because we need that prayer. And we thank you for it. I'm talking about those godly prayers that you
righteous prayers.
Yes. And we thank you. And I thank each one of you that reach out. Oh, hallelujah. I thank God for the Team Jesus members and those that are going to be coming. God is mending. You hear me? Because everybody can't come up here and sit on this platform. It's going to be those that are hand selected and chosen by God.
Amen.
At a time such as this. So I welcome you to God be all the glory. And at this time, I yield to co-host Apostle Precious that she can go forth with the and an opening prayer. Yes.
Amen. I too welcome you to Ministerial Engagement, where God shows up and he shows out of his spirit through his word, using his chosen handmade vessels. God don't leave no stone unturned.
Yes.
He reveals the secret and deep things to his prophets, through his apostles, most of all through his holy word.
Yes.
Where these three women that truly love the Lord God Almighty.
Oh, yes.
Are willing to do whatever God has given us to do in these very last and evil days. Yeah. Amen. Amen. It will come from Psalms 103, verses 1 through 5, King James Version. And it reads, "Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name.
Hallelujah.
Bless the Lord, O my soul. And forget not all his benefits, who forgiveth all thy iniquities, who healeth all thy diseases.
Yes, thank you, Lord.
Giveth thy life from destruction, who crowneth thee with righteousness, with loving kindness and tender mercies, who satisfy thy mouth with good things, so that thy youth is renewed like the eagles." The word of the Lord already blessed. Let us bow our heads for a word of prayer. Father God, we just come before you this evening, this afternoon, Lord God, just blessing your high and your holy name in the matchless name of Jesus the Christ. Father God, we ask your forgiveness for anything that we thought, said, or did that was out of your will, with our motives, our attitudes, our intentions, oh God. We ask you to wash us, cleanse us from all unrighteousness, everything that's not like you. We ask you to deliver us right now in the name of Jesus. We just ask you to come on in and catch us by the very reins of our mind. Catch us by our spirits, oh God, and use us for your glory and your honor and your praise, even now, Lord God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Holy Ghost, come on in and saturate our very being. Saturate us with your presence, even now, even now, Lord God. We know you already up here. We invite you even the more to come on in. We surrender our total beings even the more right now. In the name of Jesus, your will be done today, oh God. In the name of Jesus, transform hearts, transform minds, deliver, oh God, heal and set free on today, oh God, through your preached word, through your mighty handmade vessel, Elder Prophetess Johnetta Little, oh God, in the name of Jesus. We come against the power of darkness, every principality, everything that's not like you, God. We bring it before you, God, and ask you to deliver and set free from the hand of the enemy, even now, Lord God. Loose the shackles off the mind, off the soul, off the heart, off the spirit, even now, in the name of Jesus. Father, in the name of Jesus. Oh, God, somebody's crying out to be delivered. Somebody's crying out to be set free. Somebody's crying out for salvation. And God, we actually hear their hearts cry even now, Father God, in the name of Jesus, like only you can, in the name of Jesus. Oh, God, just have your will and your way, oh, God. Let your righteous reign supreme on today, oh, God, in the name of Jesus. Send forth healing. Send forth peace of mind. Send forth love, oh, God, in the name of Jesus. Send your love, not our love, not man's love, because man's love is finite, but your love is infinite. Your love, oh, God, surpasses all understanding, oh, God, in the name of Jesus. Oh, God, in your love, there's healing. In your love, there's peace. Amoshe, in the name of Jesus. Oh God, have your will. Have your will today, Lord God.
Hallelujah. Yeah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. By your power today, Lord God. Oh God, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior, we do say amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you, God.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, God, Abash.
Hallelujah.
Amen. I have, amen. Right now, I'll be reading from Deuteronomy 18:18, and it reads, King James Version, I will raise them up a prophet from among their brethren, like unto thee, and will put my words in his mouth, and he shall speak unto them all that I command him.
My God.
Amen, amen, amen. I have the best privilege to introduce to some and present to others our very own sister, Elder Prophetess Johnetta.
Be the glory. Amen.
Mighty anointed woman of God, sanctified, set aside for God's use.
Amen.
Yes. Amen. Man has tried to use her so many times, but God said, not so. Amen. She's my vessel, and I will use her as I please. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. She's married to Deacon Ray Little. She's a mother and a grandmother. She served under the pastorship of Pastor Thurman Power and Lady Deborah Power, and under the leadership of founder of God Cannot Lie Ministries, Mother Prophetess Jesse McLaren. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Elder Prophetess Johnetta Little is a mighty woman of God. She's a teacher, Holy Ghost filled, and she's a mighty teacher of God's word. She gives us what God would have her to give us. Yeah. She speaks only what God says for her to speak. She don't say nothing more. She don't say nothing less.
Thank you,
and
Lord.
God uses her in such a mighty way. She has a love that surpasses all understanding. She loves the unlovable when they don't even love themselves. She takes a kind of love on them and does a change because God uses her to love the unlovable. The next voice you hear will be our very own Elder Prophetess Johnetta Little.
To God be the glory. Thank you. Glory, glory, glory.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The songs that what we are playing, we do not own the rights to the song. However, we encourage you to add them to your music collection.
Yes.
The names of the songs are in the Facebook post, so you will know the name of the song and the artist that sings.
Glory
also,
to God.
A while ago, I think I said Amos 3:5. If I did, I meant Amos 3:7.
Amen.
Regarding the prophet. And so I want to make sure that I have gave you the right scripture so that way you can go and study on your own time.
Hallelujah.
God be all the glory. Oh, hallelujah. And after the song, as Apostle Precious saying, the next voice, we're going
to
be hearing a message from the prophet, elder of God.
Glory to God. And hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you.
to fall asleep. There was so much on my mind, searching for that peace, but peace I could not find. So then I kneeled down to pray, praying, help me please. And he said, you don't have to cry, I'll supply all your needs.
As soon as I stopped worrying,
when I let go,
yes, hallelujah.
Hallelujah, bless the Lord. Hallelujah, glory to God. Let go, let God. Let go and let God, hallelujah. The battle is not yours. As soon as you let go and stop worrying, hallelujah. Glory to God, hallelujah. I bless the Lord, it's another Friday night, hallelujah. And just fellowship, and there is a word from the Lord. Glory to God. Hallelujah. I want to first and foremost praise God and honor him for his power, his presence, and his anointing. Glory to God. And without him, we would be nothing. Without him, we would not be able to do this. This is God's platform. form. Glory to God. And he can do anything he wants up here.
Amen. Yes, he can.
We blocked or unblocked, he can do anything he wants to. Hallelujah. And it will come through. Glory to God. Hallelujah. I want to honor the visionary. Glory to God. And her beautiful co-host, my sisters. Hallelujah. I get all giddy. Hallelujah. Because, you know, I haven't been up here with them all week. But let me tell you something. Go back and watch the broadcast from this week. These ladies were on fire.
Praise God.
Fire all through the week. Glory to God. Coming forth and giving the word. Woo! It was amazing. But I've got to stop listening to them while I'm driving. Glory to God. Because at any moment, hallelujah, I just want to pull over in the dark and just get out and run around. But God is truly blessing. And there's an anointing, hallelujah, glory to God, that is unlike none other. I mean, last week was, it was incredible. If you have not watched, please go back and watch the broadcast from this past week. I'm not going to get into it, but please, you will not be disappointed. Go back and watch. Glory to God. Hallelujah. I praise God for my pastor, Pastor Thurman Powell, his beautiful wife, Lady Deborah Powell, sending love and hugs to you, Lady Deborah Powell. Glory to God. Praise God for my spiritual mother, hallelujah, overseer, founder of GCL Ministries, along beside her husband, my papa pastor, overseer, Jesse McLaurin. I praise God for you, your wisdom and your strength, lady. You are one of the most anointed saints that I know, and I praise God for what he's pouring into you. Glory to God. Hallelujah. So, Friday night, and we are ready to get this party. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. But let us pray. Father God, we just thank you for this time. We thank you, Lord God, for the word that's going to come forth. Thank you, Lord God, for the teaching. Father God, I thank you for giving me a heart to be obedient, Lord God, because I wanted to teach something else and you said, no, not so. So Father God, here we go. I yield completely to you. Have your way. Rise up in me, Holy Spirit, to get the people exactly what they need in this time span, Lord God. Bless them. Bless them mightily that they will be receiving of the word and that they will be blessed in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Okay. So there is a word from the Lord on tonight. And as I was praying and getting ready and spending time with the Lord, I was all excited about another word. And God said, we're not finished. He said, I might get somebody else to do that. You're not doing that. And he made it known to me that this message, this teaching is a continuance of when we sin, glory to God. And if I had a title, it would be, I have fallen, but I will get up.
All right now.
Fallen, but I will get up, glory to God. So God is really amazing in this teaching. He was ministering to me, even things that, you know, I go through on a regular basis. Sometimes, you know, the scripture came up or the remembrance of the message that was preached not too long ago, no doubt. I found myself in that a little bit after a doctor's appointment, but no doubt got me. No doubt it's going to be all right. No doubt that he is a healer. And then he came forth and brought that testimony of my dear sister, my little niece, hallelujah, and how God is just, because we know that God is a God, can do anything. He can do anything, glory. Nothing is too hard for him. So we're going to go ahead and get started. And I want you to understand, if you're in a backslidden condition tonight, this is especially for you, hallelujah, because we have gotten so conditioned, hallelujah. See, there's a great falling away. People are falling away, and I truly believe the way God ministered it to me, those ones that are in that backslidden condition, they've been deceived into thinking that they're so horrible that they can't come back. But I'm here to tell you on tonight, you can come back. And after you hear what God is telling you on tonight, it's good as done, hallelujah. I'm trusting God for the favor on your life. I'm trusting God to make you remember where you came from. I'm trusting God to bring himself back to you bigger than ever before. Yes, and yes. I know he's going to deliver you out of your mess. You know why? Amen. Delivered us out of ours. Glory to God. Yes. We tell you all the time that he is no respecter person, and he loves you with an agape love, a love that really we can't even explain. But he wants you back, hallelujah. Even though the enemy wants to sift you with wheat, glory to God, it's not so if you don't let him. Hallelujah. So tonight, what an appropriate song. Let go. Let God, come on back home. Hallelujah. Battle choice. Glory to God. What an appropriate beginning. Glory to God. So the first scripture that I want to go to on tonight is really going to bless your heart. It's Proverbs 24 and 16. I want to read a couple of versions to you. And for, let's see, we'll go with the King James version first. Glory to God. Hallelujah. The word of God reads, for a just man falleth seven times and riseth up again, but the wicked shall fall into mischief. Amen. All right. New Living Translation. The godly man may trip seven times, but they will get up again. But one disaster is enough to overthrow the wicked. Hallelujah. New International version says, for though the righteous fall seven times, but they rise again, but the wicked stumble when calamity strikes. You know why they stumble and fall? Because they don't have that solid foundation.
Come on
they
now.
They don't get that battle axe. Hallelujah. They don't have the God that is there in the time of trouble. Hallelujah. And the wicked does not have the Lord going before them to make the crooked way straight. Hallelujah. Yeah. So we bless God on tonight. Again, remember, this is a continuance from when we sin. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord. We're going to learn, hallelujah, right now, how to stand up again. Y'all remember that commercial that comes on, glory to God, hallelujah, that the lady falls down and she falls and she says, I've fallen and I can't get up. Hallelujah. That's in the natural, glory to God. But we fall spiritually sometimes, whether you get away from your prayer life, have fallen into a place because of circumstances and conditions in your life. Sometimes things hit us hard. Sometimes, believe it or not, folk don't even want to pray. Hallelujah. Believe it or not, sometimes we get to a point, hallelujah, where we don't feel like praying. Hallelujah. On the inside of us, the Holy Spirit, he leads, he guides, he teach us. You have to understand that we live in these fleshly bodies, and if we don't have the Holy Spirit, it is lined up for destruction. Glory to God. But as long as we have the Holy Spirit, we shall live and we shall live again. Glory to God. This is for everyone, but for every person that feels trapped in their own sin and shame on tonight, you will get delivered, glory to God. It's those who enter worship service on Sundays and they have a heavy heart when they go in and a heavy heart when they come out. They remember what the Lord thy God taught or what was preached on that day, hallelujah. And because of feeling unworthy, glory to God, they fail to believe the promises of God, hallelujah. We are donned in our purple on today because it represents the royalty of God. One of the lets us know that we are a chosen people. Glory to God. We are his. So if God is king, hallelujah, we're princes and princesses. Hallelujah. We're donned in our purple on tonight. Whether you are in a backslidden condition, glory to God, come on back home and put your purple on, baby. Because enough, hallelujah. God wants to drape you. He wants to clothe you first and foremost in his blood. Glory to God. Hallelujah. There's a rejuvenation coming. Oh, there's a rejuvenation coming. Hallelujah. You've been down and out long enough. Hallelujah. So when you have found yourself, hallelujah, and you're confronted with the reality of sin in your life, more specifically, there is a very healthy way of repenting. Glory to God. We have to understand, number one, that sin is something that keeps us away from God. There's no sin in him. Glory to God. It means to miss the mark. Hallelujah. When we sin, we can't be in his presence. Hallelujah. We can't do those things. Now, my sisters and I had a real good discussion the other day, as not being sinners, but knowing that we do sin. Yes. On a daily basis, and we must repent on a daily basis. Yes. Some of you, hallelujah, you're just beating yourself half to death, glory to God, instead of just repenting, hallelujah. Yes. But there are some of you that have fallen deep into what you used to do, and you've actually given up, hallelujah, because you feel like you have betrayed the Lord. You're feeling guilty. You're feeling condemned beyond repair. Who told you? Who told you that you couldn't come back to God? Standing there, still knocking on the door. Why do you think you haven't met your demise? Because he wants you back. And all the mess that you've done over the past year, the Lord is saying you've been awful the past year. You've been in some stuff. You're even worse than you were before you came to me. But I'm telling you, baby, I'm still right here waiting on you. I haven't let you die in your sin. I want you back. And I'm not going to budge until you come back, because your heart deep inside there, I can still reside. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
This is for somebody. You've been terrible. Glory to God. You've been terrible openly. And people are looking, what happened? Glory to God. But guess what? It's time. And tonight, you coming back home. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Original missed the mark. The mark refers to the standard of perfection according to the word of God, according to his will. Hallelujah. No, nobody's perfect. Glory to God. But we as children of God, we live in the statutes of our Father. He's laid down some things that we must and we will do as children of God. He expects that of us. And when we make a commitment to him, that's what we do. And even when we feel like we can't do it, his precious Holy Spirit rises up and he makes everything possible. It's not of our own doing, but God is not going to tell you to do something that you're not able to do.
Man,
whether it's physical or whether it's mentally, he's not gonna, he will make a way of escape from temptation and all those things the devil tries to trap you in. Glory to God. But when thinking about sin, we have to let you know that it's very important that it violates multiple parties in your life. Sometimes you look at sin, it's like, well, you know, they don't know about it. And, I'm not hurting anybody. I'm doing it in secret, but you're not doing nothing in secret, baby. God sees all and he knows all. That's what you should be worried about. Not what man sees, but what God is actually seeing. So it hurts multiple parties. First and foremost, God, just like I said, and then another person. You know, you can see sometimes, you can discern that something is not right. That's why God gives us discernment, so that we know how to pray and we understand what we're getting in the midst of when we're in the presence of people. Hallelujah. That is a gift of God. And sometimes when we're looking at people, we can see things that other people don't see. Glory to God. Hallelujah. I can tell you some stories if God would allow me. Hallelujah. I tell you, discernment is a beautiful gift, but it can be scary. Especially when you're dealing with the church. You're dealing with people in the church. Glory to God. And when you see something, sometimes you say, Lord, they're not going to believe that I see this. They will hang me out to dry if I say something. So you also have to be very careful once you see to only reveal to those that God wants you to reveal to. Because
you're teaching, woman of God, walking heavy.
To snatch the covers off of everything that ain't right. Hallelujah. Because he's coming back for his church. And if the church ain't right, hallelujah, he's snatching them covers off, honey.
Yes, you
will buy your time if you're not a true apostle, if you're not a true bishop, if you're not a true teacher or preacher, you may as well bide your time because God is getting ready to do a great exposure.
Yes, he is. Teach, woman of God.
Amen. But let's get back. Because you coming on home. Amen.
Yes, they are.
First and foremost, sin is an offense to our God. Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. It goes against his very nature. It's not in his nature. He can't be in the presence of it. Hallelujah. For example, lying is a sin. And because God cannot lie, he can't be in the midst of that. Secondly, sin violates yourself as well as the person that you brung into it.
Come on now.
It violates you and the almost unknowing person. So beware, you pastors.
Come on here.
Who are not teaching and preaching the unadulterated word of God. And your people are falling into stuff that they got no business falling into. And God, you are charged over their lives.
Teach, woman of God. Preach.
So understand that. It violates them too. Yeah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God.
God, my God. Ooh, walk heavy.
Destruction and ultimate death is going to come your way. And that's as prophetic as it gets. You better repent and get yourself together. Those of you that are in charge of God's precious people.
My God.
And you're leading them the wrong way.
Jesus.
Time is short.
Ooh, bye.
God sees you. He sees you.
Yeah. She does.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Jesus.
We have to understand acknowledging sin and repenting and moving forward is vital.
Yeah.
As long as there is breath in your body, you can come back home.
Yes.
Yeah, you've been terrible.
Mm-hmm.
You think about the disciples. Hallelujah. Glory to God. How Peter denied Christ three times. Didn't think he could do that. Didn't think he had it in him because, you know, he was Jesus' right-hand man. He's like, look, he'll cuss you out and cut off your ear. That's how much he loved the Lord. Glory to God. Hallelujah. But he denied him, not one time, two, but three.
Yes.
But when he repented, the Lord was right there.
Yes, he was.
Yes, he was.
Hallelujah. Being disobedient. Hallelujah. Mm. You think about David and how he was a murderer and an adulteress.
Yes.
Glory to God. But when he came back to God, God said he was a man after his own heart. Just think about who God used for his glory. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
One of the hardest mindsets for us to break is the one that comes when you know you're living in sin and you know that it's the wrong thing to do. So you know the word, so you're really condemning yourself to hell because you already know. But if you really truly understand what God is doing in you, glory to God, you know that he loves you with a love that you will never understand, and you can come back. You can wipe that slate clean. You are the one that's condemning yourself. He is waiting for you to come on back home.
Yes, he is.
He wants you to come back home. Hallelujah. That's why the enemy is so quick to want you dead. In this past year, you've gone through things. Hallelujah. And you understand that you could have been dead, but you didn't think why you're not dead. You're trying to think about why you're not dead. Yeah, you could have been, but why aren't I dead? Because God still loves you. And he wants to use you for his glory. He wants to pick you up. And I just dropped by to tell you what he said. And it's going to be up to you to receive it. Now, if you keep walking in sin, damnation is your name.
Oh, Jesus.
Come on back home.
Yes, come on.
Talk to God about it. Yes. Hey, look, you can never get too dirty that the blood of Jesus can't wash you clean.
Yes. Yes.
My God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The accuser wants you bad. Why does he want you so bad? Yes. Have you ever thought about that? Why does he want you so bad? Because you're a threat to him.
Uh-huh.
You are a super threat. That's why he tries to hold that grip on you. And you've given him a listening ear. So therefore, you have allowed yourself to be deceived. But baby, God's got it. Come on back home so you can be good. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You know, the enemy wants to make us all believe that we're no good, that we don't do anything for God. You know, sometimes doubt arises. Sometimes, you know, sometimes you won't even believe who you are sometimes when you look in the mirror. But God is showing you who you are so that you will know that it's not you, it's him that's taking it.
Yes.
Hallelujah. On the platform, he started with one woman that gave him an ear. Hallelujah. Yeah. She thought many times, you know, Lord, I can't do this. Why would they listen to me? No doubt. Moses, hallelujah. Why would they listen to me? And God said, because I'm in it. I say so. Hallelujah. And God has anointed this platform to help his people so that they would get the word of God. And my sisters are diligent every day of the week. And if I didn't work a natural job, I'd be right up there with them.
Hey, y'all. Amen. Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. Amen. That our sin is too great for God to forgive. Who make that decision? Who do we think we are to speak about what God is thinking about us? Because when he was up there on Calvary, honey, where he hung, bled, and died, look, if he didn't come down then, he didn't waste his death. That you're too dirty to come back. He didn't waste that time.
Preach, woman of God.
Exactly. He is looking for you to come back to him. Restoration right now in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus. Yes.
Stop your petty patting. Hallelujah. Yes. And whining about who you are right now.
My
glory, the God of who you are.
Yes.
And what he's doing for you right now. He's meeting you right where you are.
Yes. In the midst
of your mess. Yes. God is able. Hallelujah. Yes.
Hallelujah.
All you have to do now is repent and accept forgiveness. The word of God already says that a righteous man falls seven times. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
A righteous one. Someone who truly knows the Lord. And the first time we do something that is not of God, then here comes the judgment for man. Did you hear about what Pastor Bonnie, Apostle Precious, glory to God, Elder Johnetta, dude, hallelujah. You know, we have this little funny running joke where sister took some pictures one time. And we were all discombobulated on those pictures. Half this way, that way, we looking all crazy. It's just how the pictures turned out. But we laughed so hard because we looked at those pictures. We were like, ooh, look like we've been drinking. And we laughed and we laughed. And you know what? If those pictures had been posted, I guarantee you there would have been a whole bunch of judgmental people saying,
you know this, you know this.
It would have. We cracking up laughing.
All you gotta do is look at the picture, and we just as right as the Christ that's on the inside of us. We just took some rough pictures that night. Praise God.
Yes.
Amen. So, you know, people, hallelujah, the backslider.
Yeah.
The Lord loves you. And I'm going to give you some great scripture in a minute. He loves you. The devil is a liar. Hallelujah.
Yes, he has
deceived you. He's made you think that you can't be saved. Oh, yes, you can. Hallelujah. Yes, you can. True repentance is really more than acknowledging sin. It is turning away from sin and back to God.
Amen.
That's all you have to do. Turn away from that mess and just go back.
Yes, come on back home.
Yes, glory to God. It's not simply saying, Lord, I repent, while seeking sin out. You have to find that your desires are sinful and pray, Lord, create in me a clean heart.
Yes, Lord.
Create in me a clean heart. Yeah. Hallelujah. And don't you know when you cry out to God like that and your heart is really, really in a state where you want the Lord, he comes to your rescue in a hurry.
Yes, he does.
I know it to be true. Mm-hmm. Glory to God. Hey, hallelujah. Jesus. You have to ask him to take these sinful desires out of my heart.
Mm-hmm.
That's where the falling away is coming. It starts with the backslider who doesn't believe that he could come back home.
Oh my God.
Hallelujah.
Jesus.
You will never get past sinful desires if you don't believe that they're there.
Mm-hmm.
If you are trying to pretend that the sinful desires don't exist, listen here. You might fool the pastor, but you can't fool the master.
Come on now.
If you are trying to act like these things are not happening, God sees them, he knows all, you may as well take it to the altar and deal with it.
Come on now.
Amen. Yes, Lord.
Deal with it. Glory to God. I'm going to help you.
Amen.
Step to repentance. Mm-hmm. It's easy. Mm-hmm. It's easy. And then you're going to think about the past year and you're going to think, oh my goodness, I failed.
Mm-hmm.
And I thought I couldn't get up. Mm-hmm. But number one, acknowledge your sin.
Yeah.
And simply ask Jesus to forgive you.
Mm-hmm.
Number two, commit in your heart to turn away from that sin.
Mm-hmm.
As difficult as it may be, if you've gotten into some fleshy stuff, the flesh is awful.
You have to
constantly pray against your flesh.
Mm-hmm.
But God can do it.
Yes, he can.
If you've gotten into situations where the Lord just said, repent.
Mm-hmm.
Repent, glory to God. Commit to your heart to turn away from that sin. Now, number three, find somebody. Now, God will always send somebody.
Yes,
somebody that you can trust. Somebody that knows the Lord and love the Lord. I had a gentleman tell me just the other day, and you know, he's, you know, in a backslidden condition, but I did plant a seed. And he said, well, you know, I'm just going to say the last name of this gentleman was Mr. Smith. He said, Mr. Smith has been in my life for 2 months. He's an older, God-fearing man. And I am really blessed to have him in my life. God will send somebody your way to help you. He uses people. He will raise somebody up.
Glory to God.
To get you to a place
where
you can hear and you can receive again. They will preach to you. They will teach to you. They will, your soul, your spirit is their very main concern that you come back to God. And I was so blessed to hear that. Glory to God. Hallelujah. God did it for me when I was in despair about losing some sisters that needed to be gone out of my life. He rose these two up with the quickness. Hallelujah. Somebody call and encourage me and bless me and always praying for me. And we just exalt the Lord together, and it's real.
Yes. It's real.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We got time for that play mess. Listen, I was trying to be for real, but the other people were like, get somebody else to do it. And guess what God did? He got somebody else to do it.
Yes, he did.
So listen to God when he brings that mature Christian into your life, into your life. They might not even, they might be there already and you not even know it. Now, this is the big one. You need to accept Christ's forgiveness.
Amen.
And realize that you stand justified in the eyes of God.
Mm-hmm.
Regardless of how dirty and filthy that you've been.
Mm-hmm.
Again, you've been terrible. And I don't know who this is for, but you've been terrible. Mm-hmm. But God says he still loves you.
Yes, he does.
So accept his forgiveness and forgive yourself.
Amen.
Forgive yourself. It's okay. It's important to confess your sin, confess them openly, hallelujah, to that person that God has sent your way, your pastor, glory to God, a counselor, a trusted friend, because this helps bring the light into that dark area.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Somebody else knows about it. Somebody else is praying for me, and no judgment.
Amen.
Yes.
And it because folk got stuff in their closet. God hasn't told you to reveal everything, but there's some things in there meant for a certain time for you to reveal to people.
Yeah.
sister told me something the other night. I was like, what? Glory to God. You know, because she is so anointed, hallelujah, and God uses her greatly, you know, you can't even picture. You can't even picture us in our sinful state sometimes. That's what God does.
Amen.
You know, I tell people all the time, I used to cuss so bad, not giving the devil any glory, but you know, that sweet little face. And you make me, and I open my mouth, woo! I put cuss words together that people probably didn't know you could put cuss words together. It was terrible. You know, cuss like a drunken sailor, child.
It was terrible.
But I praise God that he created in me a clean heart. And then hallelujah, this unruly tornado in my mouth, he uses it for his glory.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, God.
That God would do it. Hallelujah.
Yes, he will. Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Get your praise on. I believe the final step of accepting Christ's forgiveness is very crucial. It's very crucial to your commitment to turn from sin.
Amen.
And once you come out of this, glory to God, you won't go back to that.
Come on.
Everything that God has ordained for you to learn in this time.
Thank you, God.
In this time where you have completely lost touch with God,
hallelujah.
Or maybe you haven't lost touch, you're just ashamed and guilty, and the enemy has deceived you. Glory to God. It is crucial that you accept what has happened, and once you talk to God, you hit the ground running and don't look back.
Yes.
Glory to God.
Amen.
When you're asking for forgiveness, speak it out loud in prayer.
Yes.
That way the devil and all his imps can hear it.
Yes, amen.
And they know for a fact that they are a defeated foe. Because what you learned in this past year, baby, walking in that nasty sin again, You will never want to feel this way again.
Amen.
In essence, because the enemy ministered to you, you fell, but God is going to rise you up. That's elevation, yeah. Baby.
Yes, it is. Amen.
That's elevation.
Yeah.
You need to move on so you can enjoy the Father.
Yes.
And I will tell you that this has happened to many, many saints.
Amen.
We've all backslidden at some point. Not all of us, but some of us have backslidden.
Yes.
And we're really confident and we would never do that.
Mm-hmm.
But something happened in a trial. Hallelujah.
Yes.
But bless God for the blood of Jesus. We're back.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, God.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
And don't ever let anybody to you. That God can fix it, that he can create in you a clean heart, that he can do some amazing things with you. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Could be that you started walking by sight. Could be, you know, that you just decided that God wasn't moving fast enough.
Mm.
And you thought that you had to fix it.
Jesus.
And when you fixed it, you made a big old mess.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Which took away from your prayer life. Hallelujah.
Because
you thought you were Holy Ghost Junior. You don't have that kind of power. You got the Holy Ghost on the inside of you, but you need to give it to God.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You have to be aggressive.
Yeah.
And you have to be on the offense with your thoughts.
Mm-hmm.
Because the enemy is going to put you in a place. Hallelujah, we're here. Bring things back to your remembrance.
Yes,
it felt so good. It felt so good when I was in his arms. Mm. It felt so good when I was in her arms. It felt so good, you know, when I could drink, hallelujah, and just, you know, cuddle up to him and, you know, light the candles and turn the lights down, Lord. That felt so good. Mm. Hallelujah. Be on the offensive with your thoughts.
Yes.
Amen. You're teaching woman of God. When the devil is telling you yes,
it is okay to do such a thing, run.
Amen. Come on now.
Say it again, woman of God. Say it again. Run.
Run in the opposite direction. If you hit and you listen, you know the word of God.
Mm-hmm.
That's one thing you haven't lost. You hear his voice. Another, you have followed, but you still know his voice. I'm talking to somebody out there. You know his voice.
Yes.
And you are just amazed right now at what I'm telling you, but it's all God.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You have to learn how to distinguish these things in your mind that are fleshly, and you must have the courage to fight them off.
Yes, yeah.
You got to have the courage to fight them off, because if you don't have the courage to fight them off, you're going to fall again, and you're going to fall some more.
Yes,
that's the word. Hallelujah. Don't you know how powerful you are when you have the Holy Spirit living right on the inside of you? Do I need to tell you about Luke 10 and 19?
Praying
for the serpents and scorpions and all the power of the enemy, and nothing by any means shall hurt you.
Yeah.
Amen.
Come on back in. Come on back in. Hallelujah. You figure, I don't know how to stop this thing that I'm in. You know, I don't know. I don't know what to do. Stop and pray.
See?
Stop what you're doing.
Yes.
Just stop it. Just say no more.
Amen.
Give it to God. Give it to God. Because he's understanding.
Yes.
And he wants to lead you back.
Mm-hmm.
He wants to rejuvenate you like you've never been revived before. Hallelujah. You got a story. You got a testimony to tell when you come out of this.
Mm.
Remember, we're in a time where the great falling away has started.
Yes,
don't you get tripped up in that. There are so many that don't think that they can come back.
Mm.
Jesus.
Our life, our Christian life, is all about glorifying the Father.
Yeah.
And kingdom building.
Yeah.
God uses us to go out and bring our sisters and brothers in. Glory to God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We enjoy the Lord because he is so good. He is the best dad ever. Glory to God. It is about, not sinning on purpose. Glory to God.
Yeah.
But it is about knowing who we are. And, even when little children wrong and their parents have caught them, and then you put those little babies on your lap and you say, baby, you weren't supposed to do that. And they're feeling all ashamed and you tell them, but I still love you, but I expect you not to do that again. And they go, yes, ma'am, or yes, sir. Amen. And then the love is still there.
Yeah.
And then in the process, that child learns something. That child learns something about the love.
Mm-hmm.
Parent gives, therefore we learn about the love that God gives and forgiveness. God will forgive us if we forgive ourselves.
Yes, got to.
Don't let the enemy deceive you.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So if you are dealing with sin that is controlling you, please consider right now at this point in time. To come on to the altar.
Yeah.
I'm not finished yet. But the Lord says, give you a minute to come to this altar.
Hallelujah.
Come and just throw all of that mess that you've been dealing with at the altar. Ask the Lord to forgive you. Creating you a clean. Hallelujah. He's just to forgive you of your sin. He's mindful of who you are. He says, I'm married to the backslider. That's enough right there. Come on in and get your life back on track.
Yeah.
He has need of you. He wants to use you. Hallelujah. There's a work to be done. And you know what I'm talking about. You know who God is. You've just gotten into a nasty predicament. But guess who's coming to your rescue today? Lord, through his son, Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Confess it. Lord, I've been a sinner. I've been nasty. I ask you to forgive me. And I know it's been wrong. But forgive me, Lord. I know who you are. I know what your son did on Calvary just for me. So I ask you right now to create in me a clean heart.
Yeah.
Get my mind right. Hallelujah. Make me the warrior I used to be. Bring me back, Lord. Take me back to the place where I first received you. Take me back, Lord God.
Yes, Lord God.
Do what you will in me. Use me for your glory. I know it to be true simply because I've asked. So, Father God, I thank you for receiving me back.
Hallelujah.
In Jesus' name. Amen.
Hallelujah.
He's so good.
Yes, he
is. He's an awesome God. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
It's amazing when we stumble and fall.
Hallelujah.
And when we stumble and fall, even physical, we get hurt. But who mends our broken bones? By his stripes, we are healed.
Hallelujah.
He's such an amazing God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
God, we stumble just as the babies do. The little toddlers, when they start walking, they stumble and fall down. Hallelujah. When they're learning to walk. And when we get older, You know, we've been walking for a lot of years. I still wear 4.5-inch high heels too.
Okay.
Amen.
And sometimes I trip up. I'll be like, oh, Lord. Because I don't want to fall down. To God be the glory. A Christian walk, glory to God, is meant to do just that. Glorify him. Hallelujah. He can do all things. Strengthen us. Amen. Hallelujah. There are always things that will make us stumble.
Mm-hmm.
I want you to understand that. We have an adversary.
Yes.
His job is to kill, steal, and destroy.
Huh?
And we know that we're good in Christ, but it doesn't change the fact that things are going to happen in your life.
Amen.
I always think on Job. He was a just and upright man. Look at all the stuff he went through.
Yeah.
And then we think we're not going to go through. We're not going to be persecuted. You know, we're not going to do anything once we're saved. That's how you get to another level. Hallelujah. You go through the cross and trust God. And listen, in the midst of that, God will show you miracles, signs, and wonders. I'm telling you.
Yes, he will.
Amen.
Amen.
Even in this, when you fell so low that you even thought that he wouldn't receive you back. Look at how God has just given you revelation on tonight. Yes.
Amen.
And I know your heart is happy. I know it is. Let's get to some scripture. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Because look at here. We have to understand. Look, God is all powerful. Hallelujah. And when we fall, we're kind of wrong for it. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The word of God.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Psalm 73:26. My flesh and my heart may fail, but God is the strength of my heart and my portion forever. Do you hear that? My flesh and my heart may fail, but God.
But God.
The strength of my heart and my heart.
Yes.
Oh, that's blessed. Philippians 4:13. We just said that. I can do all things through him who strengthens me. Remember, it's the strength of God that's on the inside of you. Hallelujah. And now that you've come back, now that you've left all that stuff at the altar, hallelujah, you better kiss them spiritual biceps. And come out all powerful and know that God is going to do a great thing in you. Hallelujah. 1 John 1:9. If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. You know, I'm going to hold a dance on that one. He is just, hallelujah, to forgive us our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. That's a done fucking drop the mic on that one. Hallelujah. Proverbs 24:16. For we read this one in the beginning, but I want you to hear it again. For the righteous fall 7 times and rise again, but the wicked stumble in times of calamity.
Yes, they do.
Aren't you so glad, hallelujah, that you've come back?
Mm-hmm.
Calamity is coming.
Yeah.
But that's another lesson.
Amen.
But I'm so glad to be back. Glory to God. Proverbs 28:13. Whoever conceals his transgressions will not prosper. We talked about this. But he who confesses and forsakes them will obtain mercy. Baby, when I tell you, it ain't nothing like spending a little time with Jesus.
Come on.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah, because he is the only one that can make it all right.
Yes.
Glory
to
God. Hallelujah. 1 Corinthians 3:15. If anyone's work is burned up, he will suffer loss.
Mm-hmm.
No, he himself will be saved, but only as through fire. Y'all remember that lesson through the fire? We go through some things in this walk, honey. We go through some stuff. Yeah. Honey, throw us in the fire. Hallelujah. Know that Jesus is there, honey. We'll come out. We won't even smell like smoke.
Amen. Come on.
Yes.
Come out, honey. Looking like, you know, where you been? I've been through the fire.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Of the blood of Jesus. Glory to God. First Peter 5:7. Casting all your anxieties on him because he what? He cares for you. The enemy has got you fooled.
Mm-hmm.
But you won't be fooled like this again.
Come on now.
This past year was rough for you.
Ooh,
It was rough. God has taught you all kinds of stuff. And in the midst of that, you know, when you come out there, you know, he gonna be fanning the flames, hallelujah, stirring up the gifts because you done seen some stuff.
Yes.
In the midst of those transgressions.
Amen.
Back quickly, 2 Chronicles 26:5. He set himself to seek God in the days of Zechariah, who instructed him in the fear of God. As long as he sought the Lord, God made him prosper. All you gotta do is seeking in everything you do, even to what earrings you wear, what clothes you wear, what color the simplest of things. What am I gonna eat for breakfast, Lord? Simplest of things. Put him in the center of everything.
Yes, come on.
Everything, yes.
A couple ways to drive to work. Which way am I to go this morning, Lord?
You can't take how many
times I've done that, and I've avoided deadly collisions on the highway.
Praise God.
Because I consulted God. Which way?
Yes.
Tell me God won't do it.
Yes, he will.
2 Corinthians 5:17. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ,
Here's
a new creation. The old has passed away, and behold, the new has come. I praise God for your newness on tonight.
Amen.
I praise God truly that you're back, because God let me know that this is for somebody. I don't know how many, but you needed to hear this on tonight.
Amen.
You needed to understand where you are and who you are and whose you are. Yes, the enemy deceived you, but that is over now. Now that you understand that what you have confessed is in the past, God is going to do a new thing in you. We all have fallen short of his glory. But now that he's given you the opportunity to get yourself together, get it together, and stay together. I'm not worried about you now. Because this new beginning, ooh, child, you talking about being on fire?
Yeah,
Lord. Oh, hallelujah.
You out of that mess, you don't know what to do. God is turning things around tomorrow morning. Listen, weeping may endure for a night, but your joy
comes in the morning. Yes, it does. Oh, hallelujah.
Yes, in 38. And the word of God says, and Peter said to them, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ for the forgiveness of your sins, and you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. If you've listened, invite him back in.
Yes.
Receive the Holy Spirit.
Mm-hmm.
Receive him. Receive him on today.
Yes.
Your life is getting ready to change. I mean, seriously, for the better. Yes. Glory to God. And sometimes, you know, when we go through these horrible things where you have backslidden and you truly have a repentant heart, God will use that stuff for his glory. You will be in the midst of people that are distraught and in despair and have no hope. And you are literally the hope.
Yeah.
Experience of what God has done in your life.
My God.
I tell you the truth. I'm just so blessed that he had me to do this. Glory to God.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Yes. You have fallen, but you can get up.
Amen.
Don't let no devil in hell or anybody else say that you can't. Hallelujah. Ephesians 6:4. Glory to God. Fathers, do not provoke your children to anger, but bring them up in the discipline and instruction of the Lord. Had something like this go down this week. Glory to God. Hallelujah. When we think about our children, we're always supposed to teach them in the way of the Lord. Hallelujah. And if they are in a place of sin, if they are in a place where, you know, they have not received, or they have received and they've started doing little things, continue to preach the word of God to them. Continue to let them know that God loves them. Continue to be downright honest and let them know that God is not pleased with the life that they're living. And if he were to crack the sky, you know, look, that was enough to put the fear in me. Look at here. If the Lord cracked the sky and I'm in my sin, what does that mean for me? If I've already learned that God cannot be in the presence of sin,
right,
and if you're doing sinful things, what becomes of me?
Amen.
Look, sometimes you give it to him, let it scare him. Amen. Hallelujah. Yeah. Let them think about some things. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Galatians 6:7. Do not be deceived. God is not mocked. For whatever one sows, that he will also reap. Okay. Get it together.
Yes.
Because whatever you're planting in that sinful nature, you're going to reap in that sinful nature.
Yes, Jesus.
But this message comes in pure love.
Amen.
Pure love. Pure love.
From the highest of high.
Yes.
You've been so rough on yourself. Glory to God. You can't even love yourself. You consider yourself the unlovable. But you can't put a limit on what God can do in your life. Just yield. Just yield. Hallelujah. And let God make the change. Once you surrender, you completely surrender, the devil has to flee.
Yes, he does.
He doesn't surrender at all.
Amen.
And there's a song that comes to my heart. I surrender all. Apostle Precious, do you know that song? I surrender all.
Amen. Yeah. All to Jesus I surrender. All to him I freely give. I will ever trust and love him. In his presence daily live. I surrender all.
Hallelujah.
I surrender all to thee, my blessed Savior. I surrender all.
Ooh, my God.
Surrender all.
I surrender, Lord God.
I surrender all.
Ooh, hallelujah.
All to thee, my blessed Savior. I surrender all.
Yes, glory to God.
Praise God. Hallelujah.
I surrender. Hallelujah. And I'm going to leave you with this last scripture. Keep this on your heart and in your mind. Isaiah 41:9 says, you whom I took from the ends of the earth and called you from his father's corners, saying to you, you are my servant. I have chosen you and not cast you off.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. God is so good. He is so good.
Yes,
hallelujah. And then those of you that have not received Christ in the pardon of your sins, glory to God. Romans 10:9 says all you have to do is confess with your mouth that you're a sinner, believe in your heart, hallelujah, that the Lord, he hung, bled, and died on your behalf. some wonder. And that's all it takes, is a conversation. Hallelujah. With the Lord.
Yes.
In Jesus Christ.
Yes.
And you can be made completely whole. Yes. He loves you with an everlasting love.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
He wants to use you for his glory.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
So come on to the altar.
Yes.
Say your prayer. Hallelujah. Father, I receive you.
Yes.
Glory to God. And he will do just that. He will show up and show out. And those of you that are willing and want to receive right now, after being saved, the gift of the Holy Spirit, just ask God. Don't be surprised when you start speaking in a heavenly language. Glory to God. You can get saved and receive him right then.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
God is so good.
Yes, he
I praise
is.
God for salvation. I praise God for the kingdom again. Hallelujah. I praise God that you've gotten so many things right on tonight.
Yeah.
Continue to talk. Continue to commune with the Father.
Yes.
He will never lead you astray.
Amen.
Amen. Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
And right now, I know that my sisters, they need to say something on tonight. God has put something in each one of them. I'm going to first yield to Apostle Prophetess Bonnie.
Amen.
And then yield to our dear sister, Apostle Precious, God's Precious. Glory to God. Hallelujah. I yield to you, woman of God.
Amen.
All the glory. As Amos, I understand why I had to emphasize Amos 3:7 regarding that God is going to reveal his word to the prophets first. Woman of God, God used you immensely, tremendously.
That's the glory. That's the glory.
And the prophetic anointing, God is warning, and he's giving a warning. You taught this word, part two, we all sin, because God is reaching out, and he let, and the thing about it, you have never done like two or three altar calls like that before. But even today, you did 2 to 3 altar calls, and you walked heavy in the prophetic because you had absolutely no idea. But Apostle Precious and I were on the phone earlier, and I keep hearing altar call just as I am for people coming. And we picked out all of these songs to wear to play when you were doing the altar call. Because he's calling for people to. Up and you taught it with such love to let people know that we all sin. There's not one person to where he's calling out, and you did it so delicately to let the people know that even the word, you even gave the apostles that failed, even Peter with his cutting off self. I mean, just cutting off people ears and everything, and to where he denied twice. You help us to understand, and those the ones that feel as though that they're unlovable, and even the actual ones that do act to where they are unlovable.
Yes.
You are loved by God, and you bring it all out, and you help the people know that it's us, and that we got to say daily. Because we sin daily. We can take somebody's pen or e-pen or say something to where we're sinning. And you help the people to know that we got to go to God daily. And I thank God for him using you to
bring
this message. And the reason why I said it's even prophetic, and I'm hearing God, because God is reaching out. Because as you walk heavy in a prophetic, you know that this time and season it is. And God is bringing forth a word to, like, you just told people to go back, and then God switched the word today. Mm-hmm. For you this week, yeah, before you even come up on the weekend, here's Friday. Mm-hmm. He's trying to get the people to go get it right, to yeah, where even they can go into the house of the God. Oh, dear God, mm-hmm, my
God. Hallelujah. Jesus, hallelujah.
Jesus. Jesus. He says that he sent his word here and now. Yes. His prophet, or you gotta see. By his prophet, or you gotta see. Because many of you have fallen, yes, and you think that you can't get up, as she said, but yes, you can, or you gotta see. And if you didn't accept the altar call that she did earlier, or you gotta see, he says, do it.
Yes.
And you're gonna wish that you had it, gotta see. It's something coming in March. Oh, you gotta see. Send this word for mm-hmm, you today, the last mm-hmm Friday. The last Friday in March. Oh, diga manasa, yeah, gotta see. And he says, woman of God, that you gotta see. He says, triple portion, or you gotta see. And he says, you haven't seen anything yet, or you gotta see.
Thank you.
Jesus. Ah. He says, you think you see things in the spirit now? There's nothing, or you gotta see. He's placing an apostolic anointing on you.
Hallelujah.
Because of hallelujah, your obedience, your yeah, obedience to be able to shift when he tells yes, you to shift, to yes, go when he tells you to go, even when you don't feel like it.
Yes,
you go for fun. And he says that he knows your heart.
Yes, like
the woman of God, she said that she would be up here with us every day. God is saying, oh, yeah, gotta see. Yes, she would. Oh, yeah, gotta see. He says, well done. Oh, yeah, gotta see. He says, woman of God, oh, yeah, gotta see. With the gift that you taught, oh, yeah, gotta see. Well done. Oh, yeah, gotta see. God is saying to follow the instructions that his prophet said on today. If you missed anything, go back and rewatch. Follow the instructions that she has given. Lord, God, I pray in the mighty name of Jesus that you replace all virtue, God, that was expelled from the woman of God. I thank you for the word that she sent, that you sent her to preach. Lord, I receive it, God. I receive it, God. And Lord God, show me me. Show us, God, all ways that we need and can do better in you, God. Lord, let your will be done in the woman of God's life. Feel me, renewed. In Jesus' name, may your will be done. Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God. Johnetta Little.
Jesus.
Amen. Mighty woman of God. As Apostle Bonnie was speaking, I heard God say, just like Noah was warning the people for 120 years, God has sent another warning through this mighty woman of God.
To God be the glory.
Right, Get into the boat, get into the ark of safety before the door is closed.
Amen.
He warning. Get your life jacket on. Get your life on.
Jesus.
People gotta be saved. They gotta be set free. They gotta be filled with the Holy Ghost. Because without Jesus, we will perish. And this is a life-giving word.
God, I thank you.
In a backslidden condition, because the devil is trying to take you out.
Oh, yes, he is.
God sent a word through her to warn those in a backslidden condition that you are not too far gone, that you can give your life back to Christ.
Come on here.
If you stay out there too long, God going to give you over to a reprobate mind because you refuse to take heed to the warning.
Amen.
I sent a word to you because he loved you just that. Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Yes, my God.
He's fulfilling the word in John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. You got to believe in Jesus Christ. You can't believe in nobody else.
That's right.
Because he said, I am the only way to the Father. No man comes to the Father but by me.
Glory.
She preached Jesus all the way through this
message. Yes, she did. Oh, hallelujah.
She ain't preached about herself. She ain't preached about this platform. She preached about Jesus and pointing. He only points the way back to the Father.
That's right.
What an awesome prophetic apostolic word that God gave.
Be the glory.
You for allowing God to use you at such a time as
to God be all the glory. Amen. Amen. I just bless the Lord for making a way for people to understand who they are. All the more, hallelujah. You know, he doesn't want us to fear, but he wants us to understand that he is always with us. Glory to God. And that he is the one that will strengthen us, and he is the one that will keep us. Isaiah 41 and 10. Glory to God, right? Isaiah 41 and 10.
Yes.
Fear not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. I will help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. And if God says it, it's a done deal. That's a done deal. We are so blessed to have served you today, this Friday. I get so giddy. I look for the opportunity. Now, I want y'all to know, I used to work every Friday. God opened a door. God opened a door. Hallelujah. And then the devil tried to close that door. But guess what? We've made some. Listen, God has done some things, so I'm very confident. Hallelujah! That door ain't closed. Hallelujah!
Amen.
God is an amazing God, and we're always very, very happy to serve you. I strongly again encourage you, if you haven't tuned into my sisters this week, please go back. Oh, the anointing power. Like I said, I'm not even going to get into that word, but please go back and look and listen and let the Spirit of the Lord just fill you up. Glory to God. It's been a mighty week, hasn't it, sister?
Yes, it has. And I thank God that today we got people from all over the globe. On Peru, we got Wilson Durant, and we got Mayla Banner from Pakistan. And I see someone else's name. I didn't see it move from my screen just then. Matthew Andrew Coley. I don't know if they're here from America, but we thank you for joining in from all over the world. And so, you know what? I feel like crying and shouting because that means that word went out to people all over to give their life to right. Yes. And you can say yes. So I thank God. Oh, yeah, God. Yes, thank God. Mm. Oh, hallelujah, God. I pray, God, that people give their lives to you.
Yes. Lord.
Hallelujah. In Jesus' name, amen. Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I get excited because I know where I was and what God brought me out of. And I just want everybody saved. Oh, hallelujah. Yes. We want everybody saved.
Yes, we do.
Oh, hallelujah. Team Jesus. Oh, hallelujah.
Team Jesus.
Yes. Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Oh, thank you, God. Thank you.
Hallelujah.
Oh, hallelujah.
Bless the Lord.
Oh, hallelujah. And I just thank God for all others. I didn't name all your names, but we just thank God for each one of you. I saw your names in your comments, and we appreciate each one of you. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, God.
To God be all the glory. I tell you, it's nothing like the love of brothers and sisters in Christ. It's an amazing thing. You know, the connection, you know, through the blood of Christ that, you know, we can love each other like this. We are true siblings in the flesh of God. So it's such a blessing. But if there's nothing else, I hope I haven't missed anything. I'm going to ask Apostle Precious to do the honors of the benediction. Hallelujah. I praise God for feeling me so, but we just praise God. Hallelujah.
Amen. Now I know who's able to keep you from falling and to present you faultless before the coming of his glory with exceeding joy.
Yes.
Be dominion and power and majesty both now and forever. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. Y'all just keep praising him. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, God.